Ayo, what's going on YouTube? Welcome back to another video, and you're probably wondering, Mark, where the fuck have you been? Well, bro, I was arrested, and unfortunately, I can't tell you anything more than that, other than I am simply dying in lawyer fees. So if you want to hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and help this ad revenue do its thing, I'm not really sure how I'm gonna pay for the lawyer just yet, but when the lawyer gives me an okay on what I can post, I can explain everything, and I can guarantee you it's not what you think. This is absolutely ridiculous, and I just had someone that was really out to get me. But aside from that, today we are gonna go over, is Sarms worth it? I have seen so many people say, yes it is. And I've seen so many people say, hell no!
No, 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 hell no!
It's not. So today, I'm gonna give you my personal opinion from my personal experience to see, is Sarms worth it? Let's roll the intro. Today we are gonna get pretty damn specific, and we're really gonna be only talking about the SARMs that will suppress your testosterone. We're not gonna be talking about carterine, and we're not even really gonna be talking about YK11, because if you saw my video on YK11, I feel that it shouldn't even be a SARM, and I really don't think people should even take it. But we are gonna be talking about RAD-140, LGD, and Ostrine. Those are probably the top three SARMs in my opinion. And if I were to rank them in terms of popularity as well as growth to side effect ratios, you basically have Ostrine, which is like very mild, super beginner. You're more or less gonna be fine if you just wanted to dabble in the art of SARMs. Then you have RAD-140. In my opinion, one of the most studied SARMs. Not the best for your hairline, so be cautious with that, but will give you amazing results with not too many side effects. And then you have LGD. LGD is for those fucking people that are just kind of not really ready to inject testosterone, but still want to try to get as much out of what they're taking as possible, and is the most potent. So those are kind of the top three that we're going to be talking about today, and we are going to be matching that to a regular testosterone cycle between 350 and 500 milligrams of testosterone. Those are kind of the comparisons that we're gonna be using today. And like I said, anything between 200 and 300 milligrams of testosterone is absolutely a pointless cycle. I already have a video on that, so make sure to go check that out. And like I said, hit that subscribe button so I don't go broke paying these lawyer fees. Anywho, are SARMs worth it? I am going to go with the answer yes. I am not saying yes because themarkplummer.com sells SARMs. I could do just as much not selling SARMs as selling SARMs. And like I said, the only reason I sell SARMs is because I was able to get a legit source that I have taken throughout every single contest prep. And I would much rather supply people with something that's real than something that is fake. It just made fucking sense to me that people will spend their hard-earned money on something that's real than bunk-ass shit from somebody that won't even stand behind their products that you paid cryptocurrency for that may or may not even show up. I think SARMs is a good alternative to steroids. There is a few things that you need to consider. Number one is the gains from SARMs will never and cannot be as permanent as testosterone. And I'm gonna put this in a layman's term, not some crazy science so no one can understand, but when you stimulate a receptor to give you a specific result, those results would never be as permanent as just injecting something that your body produces naturally. At the end of the day, if you are injecting 500 milligrams of testosterone, your body knows that very, very well. And two, you could never take 500 milligrams or 400 milligrams worth of testosterone by a pill form. And even if you were to do a pill form, I feel that your receptors would not even be able to tolerate nor digest or absorb that amount or that dosage. So you could never get the same result from these two separate things. But with that said, testosterone shuts down your body's natural production. It's done. It's gone. Poof! It's right out of the fucking park. And until you come off and do a proper PCT, it ain't coming back, bro. It's like the ex that left you 3 years ago. She ain't coming back. But SARMs, on the other hand, given that this is going to be dose dependent, will only suppress your natural testosterone. It will not completely shut down your testosterone limit. So if you are on the fence about doing something like anabolics or anything in the untested realm, it is better to suppress your natural testosterone instead of shutting it off completely, when this is something that you don't even know if you want to do, or something that you don't have that much knowledge about. Because after a testosterone cycle, you need to be on point with your PCT. You need Novadex, HCG, Clomid to bring your natural testosterone back to where it was. Whereas a SARM cycle, if you just did Novadex, or you just did Clomid, or you just did HCG, or hell, if you actually had no idea what the fuck you were doing, which I would never recommend doing any of these things without doing years or at least months of research on, you are less likely to fuck up your entire body from a SARM cycle than you would from a testosterone cycle. When you start taking these type of anabolics or SARMs, your entire life changes. And I've said this in several videos. You no longer get better year around. But a SARM cycle, due to how mild it is, you don't have to break your year apart in sections as much as you do from a testosterone cycle. A testosterone cycle, you have to basically plan your 3 to 4 month cycle. Then you need to plan an 8 week PCT. Then you need to plan on maintaining what you just gained from that testosterone cycle, and then spending enough time off testosterone to then again do another cycle and try to plan your year accordingly. SARMs is completely different, because SARMs is giving you kind of a final touch on a physique that you feel is already good, in my personal opinion. The only time I've really used SARMs was to get ready for a beach day, or to look good in a couple weeks without having to put my body under the abuse of anabolic steroids. You guys know that I would only do one cycle a year, and I would come off the rest of the year. So I would do a 6 week cycle of Rad 140 at 10 milligrams a day, just to try to look good for that Hope volleyball beach day, because I knew that my entire life didn't have to revolve around that cycle. It is a lot of these SARMs are not liver toxic whatsoever for me personally. So I could take these SARMs and drink. I could take these SARMs and still go out with my friends. I could take these SARMs and still have a balanced life and look better than someone that was staying natural. But when I take a testosterone cycle, or have testosterone with like a stack of Test, Tren, and Anavar, I'm not drinking on those cycles. My entire life is revolving around that cycle, and my entire existence and well-being is how I can maximize that cycle to, one, make sure I don't lose those results after I come off everything, and two, maximize the results while I'm actually on it. Because like I said, guys, it is very, very hard to maintain the results that you get from SARMs. It's a very good stepping point to show you guys how it feels, but other than that, you aren't gonna be retaining these massive amounts of muscle after a SARM cycle because it's just not how your body was designed to retain muscle. Now I'm telling you that, and you will retain a few pounds, don't get me wrong, but it just won't nearly be as much as something as a regular testosterone cycle. Those are just a few key points that I've experienced over my last, well, man, it's been like 4 years kind of doing this now. And I mean, just because it's my opinion, it doesn't have to be right. I ain't no doctor. I'm just purely sharing this out of entertainment purposes. So I hope this gets your mind thinking, because like I said, guys, this channel is just to get your mind thinking. It's trying to give you guys a different perspective on what other people are saying so that when and if you decide to take this route, you have so much information that if something happens, you know that, oh, I think I heard that somewhere, or you just have so many different perspectives that you can make the best call for you, because you are the only fucking person that matters in this entire world. Don't give a fuck who is saying what about you. This life is about growth. It's about fulfillment. And why the fuck should you care about some random ass person saying, well, fuck him, he's doing that. Is that gonna give you guys the fulfillment that you want, that you deserve to have? This is a 1 in 300 trillion chance that you're even existing right now. And you're gonna listen to some no-name try to talk you out of doing something that you feel is gonna bring you fulfillment? So at the end of the day, do what's best for you. Take chances. Don't look back, but be as smart as you possibly can. So we are headed off to the gym. I'm gonna take you guys through a shoulder day for mass. So if you don't give a fuck about my workout, make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. We're gonna get back on the consistent uploads now that all of these things are kind of settled down. I'm sure I will have a video explaining all of what happened last week very, very shortly. And if I don't, well then, that's a bigger issue. So I'll see you guys in the next video if you're tuning out. And if not, I'll see you in the gym. What's going on? So we're on that Miami time right now. It is 10:10. This is like our regular time to train right now because Miami traffic is so crazy. But you know, that is no excuse. We just actually have tap water here. But we got Gorilla Mind, the best fucking flavor. Mango peach. And today, we're gonna be going over my shoulder day for mass. Let me just take one of these bad boys. There was like a massive clump in there for some reason. I know, cause like, citrulline and humidity, like heats up, like when citrulline gets hot, it clumps. And like usually I'll like scrape this shit first. But I fucked up there, so I guess we're doing like 1.5 scoops today. So where was I? I had a torn infraspinatus for the longest time. I was taking like 1 milligram of BPC-157 and TB-500 for like the last 2 months off the markplummer.com, and I'm finally back to pressing. I'm finally back to shoulder raising. So I figured, why not show you guys how I train when I was trying to get as big as possible. Obviously, we have a gyno surgery in like 3 freaking weeks now. So my goal isn't to really put on tons of mass before this surgery, but after the surgery, I'm gonna be training like this every single day. And we're gonna do like a huge, like bigger by the day, like resurrection of Rich Piana series, all the way back to me competing at a national level. So I'm gonna take you guys through 1 set of every single exercise and give you a tip per exercise. And let's see how big we can get these shoulders today. Good job. So we're gonna start with military press. Always start with those compound movements. We're actually on set number 4 right now with 115s. Today, I pyramided up in weight, and then I'm just doing several top sets. I'm gonna do one crazy set after this, which I'm gonna post on Instagram and TikTok. So if you're not following me on there, I'm probably gonna go up to like 130s or 140s and crank them out. But we're gonna grab the 115s, and this is my fourth set. We're trying to get anywhere from 8 to 15 reps. My shoulders are exhausted, but let's break down this tissue. One more to go.
God damn.
Moving on to our second exercise, side delt raises. These usually, you're supposed to be like super strict and feel your side delt. Fuck that. Second exercise, you still have to go heavy. So we're gonna grab like 50s, 55s or 60s. And we're just gonna bang out as many reps as possible. If you still have size to grow, you should not be sitting there isolating your fucking muscles. Anyone that sits there isolating the muscles looks like shit and usually is small as fuck. So grab some heavy weight and put on some big boy muscle. It's the only way you'll grow. Don't be afraid to get those swingers in there. That's how you grow. All right guys, so exercise number three, we're going upright. Usually I do rear delts first, but because we're like in a mass building phase, you could say, I'm doing all like ridiculously heavy compounds, and then I'm gonna do three rear delts to finish the workout off. And usually I do those like back to back to back to back to the point when I leave the gym, I can't even like move my arm backwards because my rear delts are so fucked. So we're doing upright rows. Again, what do we always say on this channel? Go fucking heavy. I'm gonna start by having a neutral grip with my hands. I'm not too concerned about using my traps. Maybe on a contest prep, I would be more concerned about using my traps, and I'd wanna isolate my shoulders a bit more to have like a desired look. But like I said, right now, we're just trying to get big. So who cares if your traps get used a little bit? Go heavy.
And through, it's true. Baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true. Baby, won't you let the light shine through.
Like, remember guys, every exercise right now is to failure. So like set one and two, you don't have to go to failure, but set like three, four, five, all the way to failure, maximum effort. Let's keep it going. We're gonna superset with the rear pec deck. Bring it right up, and then just blast dumbbell flies. Again, you don't wanna be able to move your shoulders after this. This ain't about heavyweight. This is about just maximal exertion and just killing the back of your rear delt. So let's do this up, and then I'll show you the last rear delt exercise. And I'm telling you guys, to the point you can't even move your fucking arms is how far you want to push this. We'll do another like three or four sets, and then I'll show you guys the last exercise. Basically, if like you have a trap machine or like a Smith machine or anything that requires you to row, you can do this, but instead of doing like a back row like this, you're gonna angle your elbow out and you're gonna pull up like this. So it's almost like It's like a fixed motion for your rear delt, but you're just manipulating the angle to hit your rear delt. It's actually a row. So I'm gonna do it, and then we're gonna wrap this up. So that wraps up the shoulder day today. Usually I'll do two or three side delts, but I've been having a separate day for shoulders, rear delts, and legs. I just threw up a little bit. That was disgusting. I've been training a little more frequent because I know I have to take 8 weeks off because of this gyno surgery, so I will hit side delts a lot harder, but that's kind of my main shoulder day for mass. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. I'm gonna wrap up this video here. I'll see you in the next one.